cave. I can't wait to break and eliminate or to be trained by snakes, so stay awake and follow and follow. Cause the temple's a trail, the stage is a cave, the mic is a third rail. A rock him, the
theme of a mic. Hey, that's not a lie.
Oh! Indian so many lessons. The deer had offered important gifts to their people, and for this reason the Senecas honored their deer as one of their clans. The Senecas wondered if the deer families ever did anything for pleasure. Surely they must enjoy their free and leisure time with their friends and their families. To find out if they did, the braves made a visit to where the deer lived, and as they approached the deer homeland, they were startled by a strange thumping and an even stranger sound. The braves stopped as they approached the place where the deer lived, and to their surprise, they discovered that the deer, both young and old, were chanting and performing a dance. The young Senecas stood spellbound with their hearts thumping and their bodies swaying right to left to the rhythm that they felt. A huge deer was leading the dancers in and out among the trees and finally guided the line of deers that followed into a large circle, where all the deer seemed to be swaying and resting back and forth and chanting to the rhythm that they felt. The great deer then led the rest of them through the circle once more and retraced their dance steps through the trees until they eventually disappeared into the woods. The braves returned to the village and reported to their people about the experience, which is still done as a ritual, as a deer chant and dance, and it is an unusual experience.
Thank you. Thank you.
said shit something bad.
Holy shit!
What?
Oh, what was that one?
Holy shit! Because they don't have any more of their own farm animals left that can make the journey.
Is everybody ready?
I know the truth for you to take. No. you ready?
Yeah. carnival chamber that was.
Rejoicing in Thanksgiving. The big fucking handshake between the Native Americans and the white man. The Europeans thought that their newly discovered Indians were savages, but not civilized, and they were below it like bears. The red man was regarded as an obstacle to the pathway advancement of civilized nations, a pediment to it, must be removed or destroyed. In 1703, the government of Massachusetts was paying £12 for every Indian scalp. Colin Nather, a Puritan minister, claimed he knew the devil was decoyed as these Indians. The greatest land grab in history, the young nation's own manifest destiny. The Spanish explorers exploited and oppressed them into services their laborers. The Dutch set a precedent for paying the Native Americans land by buying Manhattan for $24. The English soon emulated this policy. The Native Americans thought this gesture was paying for the land was by sharing the land. 1830, Andrew Jackson signed the Indian Removal Act, allowing bloodthirsty authority of getting the red man's land and skinning them out of the white man's landscaping goals. One of the first debates of the Colorado legislature was over a bill authorizing bounties for the dead Indians in 1864 at Sand Creek, Colorado, after a massacre. They had an exhibit of 100 Cheyenne scalps. 300 Sioux were killed at Loon Mutiny in South Dakota after they were gathered to perform the ghost dance. By 1870, it cost the U.S. government $1 million for each Indian they had killed. At their rate, it was cheaper to keep them alive. Treaty making period ended in 1871. No tribe was acknowledged as an independent nation. They were warred to the government, impoverished, diseased reservations. Native American children were taken away to boarding schools and were forbidden to practice their native religion, their dress, and their own tongue. In a 60-year period, 86 million acres of the best Native American land was taken away from them. After the Miriam Survey in 1920, the Indians got a new deal with Roosevelt in the 30s. The Reorganization Act of 1934, Indians were eligible to vote except on bills pertaining to them. Their cultures had tribes, and they were to be recognized. The U.S. would fund them so they could be self-sustaining. The white man speaks with a forked tongue. No money from the Depression and the defense funds were needed for the World War II. Indian Bureau encouraged the Native Americans to relocate in the cities where they were forced to be tough with racism and a competitive white workforce. Taxes on reservations would soon make the Native American bankrupt in short order. Unemployment rate up to 80% on the reservations through 1970. Annual income below the poverty level. Death rates 40 times greater through the red man than through the white man at this time. The tribes lived in fear of the future of the policies of the native government that was forced upon them to refer to determination. Peoples cannot swiftly be remodeled to adapt to cultural patterns which are not in harmony with their aspirations.
ideas, beliefs, and concepts that are holding us back from experiencing riches. That clearing could include the idea that there's not enough for everyone, or that because of the economic recession, money is scarce, or the jobs are scarce. It might be a belief that you can't always have what you want. All these beliefs are not based on truth. What they're based on are other people's opinions and ideas. When you accept the beliefs of others that are not based on truth, but based on their fears, doubts, and limitations, when you accept those, they become yours, and then you manifest those in your life. So you must, in a sense, go in the exact opposite direction that most people are going. Because people are your followers, not leaders. You have to think for yourself, and not understand the truth about your own life.
Last call to the bar.
Second thing you must do is to affirm what you want to believe about your own...